Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Many times I receive some questions from those interested in the field of extracting gold from stones. I have received this question from someone interested in the field and a follower of the channel. I thank him in advance for asking this important question for anyone interested in the field of gold extraction from stones. Extracting fine gold powder. The question is as follows. If the gold is in the rock very fine like powder, please I need advice in how to extract this kind of gold from this type of rock. And what is the best process to extract powder gold from rock? Extracting fine gold powder from rock can be a challenging process, but there are several methods that can be used. Here are a few common techniques for extracting gold from rock. I hope that you will watch the video until the end in order to benefit more, because this information is very important for anyone interested in the field of extracting gold from stones. The first step is to crush the rock into smaller pieces. This can be done using a hammer or specialized machinery, such as a jaw crusher. Once the rock is crushed, it is then ground into a fine powder using a ball mill or other grinding equipment. Gravity separation methods, such as panning or sluicing, can be effective for separating gold from the powdered rock. These methods rely on the density difference between gold and the surrounding rock particles. By swirling the powdered material in water, the gold particles will settle at the bottom due to their higher density. Chemical methods can be used to extract gold from powdered rock. One common technique is cyanidation, where a weak cyanide solution is applied to the powdered rock. The cyanide helps dissolve the gold, allowing it to be extracted. However, cyanidation can be hazardous and requires proper safety precautions. Amalgamation involves using mercury. To extract gold from the powdered rock, mercury forms an amalgam with gold, allowing it to be easily separated. However, mercury is highly toxic and should be used with extreme caution and proper safety measures. Leaching involves using chemicals such as cyanide or acid to dissolve the gold from the powdered rock. This method is commonly used in large-scale mining operations but requires careful handling and environmental considerations. Froth flotation is a commonly used method for separating minerals from their ores. In this process, the finely ground rock powder is mixed with water and specific chemicals called collectors. Air bubbles are then introduced into the mixture, and the hydrophobic gold particles attach to the bubbles, forming a froth that can be skimmed off to separate the gold. Electrostatic separation utilizes the different electrical conductivity of minerals to separate them. The powdered rock is charged by passing it through an electric field, causing the gold particles to become positively charged. The charged particles are then attracted to negatively charged plates or grids, allowing for their separation. Cyanide leaching is a widely used method for extracting gold from low-grade ores. The finely powdered rock is mixed with a weak cyanide solution in a controlled environment. The gold forms a soluble complex with cyanide, known as a cyanide complex, which can be further processed to recover the gold. Carbon in pulp or carbon in leach, these are common methods used in large-scale gold mining operations. The finely powdered rock is mixed with a cyanide solution and activated carbon is added. The gold cyanide complex adsorbs onto the surface of the carbon, which is then separated and treated to recover the gold. Roasting involves heating the powdered rock in a controlled environment, which can oxidize or volatilize certain minerals, leaving the gold behind. Smelting involves further heating the roasted material to a high temperature to separate the gold from other impurities. It's important to note that the suitability and effectiveness of these methods can vary depending on the specific composition of the rock and the concentration of gold. Magnetic separation is a technique used to separate magnetic minerals from non-magnetic minerals. If the gold particles in the rock are associated with magnetic minerals such as magnetite, they can be separated using magnetic separators. Ammonia cyanide leaching. This method combines ammonia with cyanide to extract gold from the powdered rock. The ammonia helps to reduce the consumption of cyanide and improves the selectivity of gold leaching. Chlorination. Chlorination is a process that uses chlorine gas or chlorine compounds to dissolve and extract gold from ores. It is often used for refractory ores that are difficult to extract using other methods. Bioleaching. Bioleaching involves the use of microorganisms to extract gold from the rock. Certain bacteria can oxidize and solubilize the gold, making it easier to recover. This method is particularly suitable for low-grade ores or tailings. Aquaregia. Aquaregia is a highly corrosive mixture of nitric acid and hydrochloric acid. It can be used to dissolve gold from the powdered rock. However, aquaregia should be handled with extreme caution due to its hazardous nature. Electroinning. Electroinning is a process where an electric current is used to deposit gold from a solution onto electrodes. It is often used in conjunction with leaching methods to recover gold from the pregnant solution. Refining with borax. Borax can be used to extract gold from the powdered rock by forming a boric gold complex. The rock powder is mixed with borax and heated to a high temperature, which helps to melt the gold and form a slag. The slag can then be further processed to separate the gold. Gravity concentration. Gravity concentration methods, such as centrifugal concentrators or shaking tables, can be used to separate gold from the powdered rock based on the difference in density. These methods rely on the gravitational force to concentrate the gold particles in a dense fraction. Heap leaching. Heap leaching involves stacking the powdered rock in a heap and applying a leaching solution to extract the gold. The solution percolates through the heap, dissolving the gold, and is collected for further processing. Microwave-assisted extraction. Microwave-assisted extraction is a relatively new technique that uses microwave energy to heat the rock powder. The microwave energy helps to break down the minerals and facilitate the extraction of gold. In situ leaching, also known as solution mining, involves injecting a leaching solution into the rock formation and extracting the dissolved gold. This method is typically used for gold deposits that are too deep or uneconomical to mine conventionally. Combination of methods. In some cases, a combination of different extraction methods may be necessary to effectively extract gold from the powdered rock. This approach can involve using multiple processes such as crushing, grinding, gravity separation, and chemical extraction in a sequential or simultaneous manner. Acid digestion. Acid digestion involves using strong acids, such as hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid, to dissolve the rock and extract the gold. The rock powder is treated with the acid, which dissolves the non-gold minerals, leaving behind the gold particles. Ammonium thiosulfate leaching. Ammonium thiosulfate leaching is an alternative to cyanide leaching and is often used for treating gold ores that are refractory or contain high levels of copper. The powdered rock is mixed with an ammonium thiosulfate solution, which dissolves the gold, allowing for its recovery. Ultrasonic-assisted extraction. Ultrasonic-assisted extraction utilizes ultrasonic waves to enhance the extraction process. The rock powder is suspended in a liquid and exposed to ultrasonic waves, which help to break down the rock and release the gold particles. Pressure oxidation. Pressure oxidation is a method commonly used for treating refractory gold ores. The powdered rock is subjected to high temperatures and elevated pressures in the presence of oxygen, which helps to oxidize and dissolve the gold. Carbon adsorption. Carbon adsorption involves using activated carbon to adsorb the gold from a solution. The powdered rock is mixed with a cyanide solution and the gold cyanide complex is adsorbed onto activated carbon. The loaded carbon is then treated to recover the gold. Flotation. Flotation is a method used for separating minerals from their ores based on their hydrophobic or hydrophilic properties. The powdered rock is mixed with water and specific reagents, which help to selectively float the gold particles, allowing for their separation. Hydrometallurgical processes. Various hydrometallurgical processes, such as solvent extraction and precipitation, can be employed to extract gold from the powdered rock. These processes involve the use of specific chemical solutions and conditions to selectively extract and recover the gold. Nanofiltration. Nanofiltration is a membrane separation technique that can be used to concentrate the gold particles in a solution. The powdered rock is dissolved in a suitable solvent, and the solution is passed through a nanofilter, which retains the gold particles while allowing the solvent to pass through. Chlorine extraction. Chlorine extraction involves treating the powdered rock with chlorine gas or hypochlorite solution. The chlorine reacts with the gold, forming soluble gold chloride, which can be further processed to recover the gold. Microwave-assisted roasting. Microwave-assisted roasting involves exposing the powdered rock to microwave energy, which helps to heat and roast the material. This process can enhance the liberation of gold particles from the rock, making it easier to extract the gold. Direct smelting. Direct smelting is a simple and traditional method where the powdered rock is heated to a high temperature, causing the gold to melt and separate from the other minerals. The molten gold can be collected and further refined. It's important to note that some of these methods may require specialized equipment, chemicals, or expertise. Consulting with experts or professionals in the field of mining and metallurgy is highly recommended to determine the most suitable extraction method for your specific circumstances.